Do Christians believe in God because their genes tell them to? Welcome to Critical Thinking Skin, where we look at how you can think about any faith-challenging message and arrive at a biblical, logical conclusion yourself. I'm Patricia Engler, and today let's look at how to apply the seven checks of critical thinking to the idea that people believe in God because they're genetically predisposed to. Part of this claim comes from different studies of twins, which found that patterns of spiritual beliefs and practices were more similar among identical twins than fraternal twins, even when the twins were raised apart. Now, the researchers themselves don't normally claim that belief in God is genetic, just that part of human spirituality seems to be genetically influenced. But the idea that religion is rooted in genetics was popularized by books like The God Gene, which linked human spirituality to a gene called VMAT2, which regulates a neurotransmitter, a chemical in the brain called monoamine. And the book speculates that spirituality gave humans an evolutionary advantage. So although researchers don't tend to say this, you might hear in the popular media or in classrooms, people implying that belief in God is just a fluke of genetics. But is that true? Well, let's think about it. Check number one of critical thinking is check scripture. Genesis explains that God created us for relationship with Him, so even if He did hardwire us with some genetic predisposition towards spirituality, that wouldn't necessarily be surprising. However, the implication that God isn't real and we only believe in Him because our genes evolved to does contradict clear biblical doctrines, which is check two, check the challenge. Check three is check the source, and clearly anyone who says we only believe in God because our genes evolved to is not starting from the worldview of God's word. So that's going to affect their assumptions. And if you look at the research behind the God Gene book, you'll find that it didn't actually link VMAT2 to belief in God so much as to a personality trait called self-transcendence. That looks at things like searching for meaning outside oneself or feeling connected to the larger universe, which is hardly the same thing as believing in a biblical creator. That's why even popular evolutionist Carl Zimmer said that the God Gene would be more accurately titled a gene that accounts for less than 1% of variants found in scores on psychological questionnaires designed to measure a factor called self-transcendence, which can signify everything from belonging to the Green Party to believing in extrasensory projection, according to one unpublished, unreplicated study. Defining terms like self-transcendence versus religion versus belief in God falls under critical thinking check number four, check the definitions. Moving on to check five, check for propaganda, we can catch the illogical persuasion in this argument by asking, is this message true or false because? So in this case, we'd ask, is a message true or false because people might have a genetic predisposition to think so? And when you think about it, you realize no. For instance, some person might have a genetic predisposition to enjoy hurting others, but that's irrelevant to whether hurting others is morally right. In the same way, how much monoamine any one person's DNA codes for is irrelevant to the question of whether or not God exists. Besides, even if genes did encode for belief in God, that would logically mean they also encode for disbelief in God. But I doubt any atheist who thinks this would say that their atheism is false because they're genetically inclined towards it. Now let's go on to check six, check for interpretations. What's the observational science here? It's that genes linked to neurotransmitters may correlate to how self-transcendent people are, and that identical twins are more likely to give similar answers to questions like, I believe going to religious services is important. Those are the facts. The interpretation is that belief in God is therefore an evolutionary fluke of genetics, and that's clearly a stretch based on evolutionary assumptions. Besides, assuming that God doesn't exist and evolution genetically wired us to think He does, to argue that God therefore doesn't exist would be circular, failing the seventh check of critical thinking, check the logic. So, there's an example of how you could respond to the claim, belief in God is genetic. For more on how to think critically about any message that challenges the Bible's teaching, you can access my other CT scan videos packed with tactics, tips, and tools that helped me as a Christian student at Secular University. Thank you for watching. Hey, it's Patricia. Just wanting to let you know that if you like these videos, are on board to share the message of biblical authority, and want to give, you're welcome to help Answers in Genesis produce more content like this and equip more people to defend their faith by making a one-time donation or becoming a monthly supporter by clicking the link below. Thanks so much.